heat engine operates between three reservoirs, R1 at 550 Kelvin, R2 at 450 Kelvin, and R3 at 350 Kelvin. For every cycle, the engine accepts 100 kilojoules from R1 and rejects 60 kilojoules into R2 and 30 kilojoules into R3. The engine efficiency is...
Engine receives 100 kilojoules. 100 kilojoules. Let it be, this is Q1. 100 kilojoules from the reservoir, 550 Kelvin. And rejects 6 kilojoules to R2, reservoir 2, render reservoir. Let it be, this is Q2, which is 60 kilojoules. This temperature is 450 Kelvin. Then third reservoir, which is at a temperature, third reservoir is at a 350 Kelvin. Rejects 30 kilojoules of heat. So, this is the diagrammatic representations. Diagrammatic representation of the given problem. You have any doubt? Diagrammatic representation. So, any heat engine receives heat from the reservoir and rejects heat to the sink. Okay. Heat reservoir, heat source. Heat source is relatively at high temperature. Sink is lower temperature. Okay. Temperature of the source temperature will be greater than sink temperature. So, this is the source. These two are sink. Heat engine. Heat engine operates between three reservoirs. It is not the reversible. If it is reversible, I can put delta Q by T is equal to 0. That is summation. Summation of Q by T equal to 0. But in given the very heat engines, normal heat engines, for any heat engine, this is important. Class name solar can. For any heat engine, efficiency is defined as, okay, the efficiency get work by heat supplied to the engine, work output. Q is heat supplied to the engine. Heat supplied to the engine, 100 kilojoules. By first law, for cycle, net work output is equal to net heat transfer, cyclic, okay? Or we can say W net is equal to Q net. This is the meaning. Okay. W net which is heat supplied to the engine minus heat rejected to the engines. This is the first law for the cycle. First law of thermodynamics for cycle, thermodynamic cycle. Now heat supplied to the engine is 100 kilojoules. Heat rejected is 60 plus 30. Okay. Heat supplied to the engine. Heat rejected by the engine is these two, 60 plus 30. Okay. So heat supplied to the engine is 100 kilojoules minus of heat rejected from the engine is 60 plus 30, about 10 kilojoules. Now efficiency is work output, or W net, or work output is divided by heat supplied. 10 by heat supplied to the engine is 100. Evalava percentage la solnumna into 100 potumna 10%. The efficiency percentage la kudukla 0.1. So it is 0.1. A similar problem. A heat pump. Heat engine receives heat from the higher temperature, rejects heat to the lower temperature. This is heat pump. Now I want to differentiate these two. Heat engine. Receive heat from higher temperature source, and reject heat to lower temperature sink. This is heat engine. Heat pump. Receive heat from lower temperature and supply heat to the higher temperature. Marandu poirupinaal na konja enna detail ah konja nadathittu irukken appa is already taught in the class. Heat engine, heat pump, or refrigerator, both refrigerator. Heat pump receive heat from lower temperature and reject heat to the higher temperature. Heat engine will deliver work, heat pump will consume work. This is work input. Let it be, this is Q1 and Q2. This is the heat pump diagrammatic representation. Receives heat, T2 is greater than T1. This is important. T1 temperature kammiya irukum, T2 vandu adhigama irukum. It receives heat from T1 and supply heat to the T2. So heat pump and refrigerator will consume work. Now statement. A heat pump extract heat at the rate of 100 kilowatt. Extract heat, that is Q1. Given is Q1. Heat pump extract. இதுல இருந்து extract பண்ணது heat, which is 100 kilowatt. Kilowatt is nothing but kilojoules per second. Rate at which heat is extracted from the T1, from the low temperature reservoir, and deliver heat at the rate of 160 kilowatt to a higher temperature. It means Q2 is 150 kilowatt or kilojoules per second. The COP of the heat pump is, COP we have to find out. Okay? COP of the heat pump is Q2, that is how much heat is supplied to the this hotter place divided by work input. This is the COP. இது refrigerator and the heat. Refrigerator COP என்னது என்ன டிஃபரன்ஸ், how much heat is extracted. COP of the heat pump க்கு refrigerator க்கு டிஃபரன்ஸ் என்ன கேட்டிருக்கு, COP of the heat pump தான் கேட்டிருக்கு. COP of the, now Q2 தெரியும், work input தெரியாது. Now work input by first law for site. Work input is heat rejected heat supply or kilojoules per second. So இந்த இடம் ரொம்ப முக்கியம்பா. How to calculate the work input? Work output na heat supplied minus heat rejected. Work input na heat rejected minus heat supplied. Please note, work output na heat supplied minus heat rejected. Work input na heat rejected minus heat supplied. Data maathi ellidren. This is 160. Answer is, this is also 160. 160 by 60. 2.67. This is the answer. The thermal efficiency of the reversible heat engine operating between two thermal reservoirs is eta max. The coefficient of performance of a reversible refrigerator cycle operating between the same two reservoirs is. Please read the problem carefully. Heat engine working between two temperatures T2 and T1 to deliver work. Then refrigerator works between the same two temperatures. T2, for this we are giving work input. Now eta max is the Carnot efficiency, the maximum. So eta max is the another in terms of temperature, 1 minus minimum temperature by maximum temperature. Okay, similarly COP of the refrigerator, Carnot refrigerator minimum temperature by temperature difference, T2 minus T1. Are you able to follow? Let it be, this is 1, this is 2. From equation 1, T1 minus T2 equal to 1 minus eta max. T1 by T2 is 1 minus eta max. From equation 2, COP of refrigerator is T1 by T2 minus T1 divided by T2 on both numerator by denominator. 1 minus T1 by, ஏன்னா டைரெக்டாக நம்ம சப்ஸ்டிட் பண்ணிக்கலாம் T1 by T2 இஸ் 1 மைனஸ் ஈட்டா மேக்ஸ். திஸ் இஸ் 1 மைனஸ் ஈட்டா மேக்ஸ் டிவைட் பை 1 மைனஸ் ஆஃப் ஈட்டா மேக்ஸ். இங்கே கேன்சல் ஆயிடும். ஸோ 1 மைனஸ் ஈட்டா மேக்ஸ் பை 1 கேன்சல் ஆகிட்டு ஈட்டா மேக்ஸ் இவருக்கு ஆர் 1 பை ஈட்டா மேக்ஸ் மைனஸ் 1. திஸ் இஸ் சிஓபி ஆஃப் தி ரெஃப்ரிஜிரேட்டர்.